Yo, y'all, before we start this video, I just want to start off by saying that we need to be very careful about what we post on the internet, because what stays on the internet is there to stay forever, even if you remove it. So this is going to deal a lot with today's topic. I hope you enjoy. Sit back, relax, and chill. Yo, what's going on, everybody? It's your boy Ras Tien in the building. I hope everybody's having a beautiful summer so far. I've been sick so far, so I've been able to do my regular Ras request like I usually do every Wednesday. But after I get over my sickness, I will get back to singing like I did before. I just want to get right into today's topic. So today's topic is going to be about the importance of image. Now, why are we talking about the importance of image? Well, from what we see in today's society, we see that a lot of women, not all, but there are a lot of women who are left-wing, who are feminists, who are encouraging women to dress in a way that is not modest, right? Not only that, but in entail, along with dressing unmodestly, they're also encouraging women to do things in a sexually rebellious way, because that's all feminism is anyway. Is just to be sexually rebellious. It's not really about women's rights. And I recently posted on my Instagram a clip of these Thai women. They were doing what I would call a twerk train to that song by Nicki Minaj, Anaconda, right? And right now, I'm going to play the clip so you can see what I'm talking about.
I got a big fat
Now, I had also showed a post that same day where I was showing a woman who had a white hoodie on, red hair that was dyed, by the way, and she didn't have any underwear on and she was poking her ass out. Now, in that comment, I said, it's funny how today's women don't want to be objectified, but yet they do it to themselves by showing pictures like this on the internet and expect to be treated like Mother Teresa. And then I said, hashtag bring back modest women, hashtag attention whore, hashtag hypocrisy, right? And I got a very disturbing comment that I came from a student of mine. I don't know who this person is, and if I knew, I wouldn't say their name, but this person sent a very disgruntled message, basically telling me, who am I to tell a woman what she should do with her body? And basically calling me a misogynist and a racist for creating the hashtag Stop Black Hate Too. Now, to anybody out there who has the nerve to tell me, who am I to tell anybody what they should do with their body? First of all, everyone tells us what we should do with our body. Even me as a man. I will have other friends of mine who are males who will tell me something such as not to fornicate, or who will give me tips about how to look for a job interview, or if I'm trying to attract women, what kind of clothes I should wear, and about wearing cologne. All things that they're telling me to do with my body to help me. But the problem is with you modern women is that when someone tells you something like this, you look at it like someone is trying to take control of you, oppress you, and make you feel like a bad person. And that's far from the case. This person is only telling you this because they care about you. They're giving you advice to help you, but you need to get it out of your mind that people are trying to control you and oppress you. Stop looking at it like that and look at it as like this. This is something that I could reflect on and think about in order to better myself. Because that's all the person is trying to do. And as a man who is a father himself, I have a daughter. So the women in that clip, I don't want my daughter to be anything like those women. I don't want her to exhibit any of those behaviors as she grows older. And there are also women who would agree with me and say that the women in that clip were trashy, nasty. They look like cheap whores. And that they're disgraceful because I know for a fact some of these women were mothers. If not all, some of them were. And they're not even thinking about the embarrassment that their children are facing. Because if these women really cared about their kids, they would think about how their kids would get teased at school when someone comes up to them and say, "Hey, I saw your mom on OnlyFans. Man, she was busting it open." Or, "I saw the video that your mom posted on Twitter, man. Her titties are nice." You're not thinking about how the child will feel like they have a mother who is an impure woman. So I think I'm speaking for the greater good when I say I want to see more righteous women walking down the street. And that's not something that's wrong. I mean, if we go back in time and we try to convince our great-grandmothers to dress and act the way that the girls today are acting like, they would be shocked and appalled. They wouldn't want to dress the way how these girls are dressing today. They wouldn't want to wear yoga pants with a crop top. They wouldn't want to walk around without a bra. Because even back then, even though these women weren't Islamic, they still believed in the concept that a woman's beauty should be for her husband. And that's what we should think about. We should be trying to go back to the way how our great-grandmothers were, or our grandparents were, the way how they used to dress, the way how they used to conduct themselves. And we should look at it that when someone is giving us advice, that we should take it that they're giving us that advice out of love, not out of hatred or out of oppression. Because this whole movement that we see today as far as trying to promote open-mindedness, let's look at what open-mindedness is doing to us today. We got people who are so open-minded, right? But they can't even tell what their own gender is. You got people walking around saying, "I'm pansexual" one minute, then the next day they're non-binary, or the next minute they're bisexual. men trying to be more feminine than the women, women trying to be more masculine than the men. You have all this confusion going on. All this confusion where we're even passing this on to children, trying to get children and influence them to saying that they identify as the opposite sex when they're not even old enough to even understand these kind of things. Let's go back to being traditional, and let's also understand that as men and as women, we have roles, and there are certain things that men can do that women cannot do, and there's certain, and the same thing goes vice versa. There are things that women can do that men can't do. That's what we need to be understanding. So for example, the expectations of a man is not the same as it would be for a woman. A lot more is expected of us as men. Even when it comes to our emotions, men show our emotions differently. Okay, these are things that we need to go back to understanding, because this new age of doing things, it's really not helping us. All right, y'all, that's all the time we have for today. Just a little food for thought. Just reflect on what I said. I love you guys. And like I said, the people who have a problem with what I'm saying, you don't have to subscribe to me, okay? You could go somewhere else. I can find a whole nother audience. There ain't no thing but a chicken wing for me. With that being said, love, peace, and coconut grease. I'll holla.